Shoot. Thank you to MBL for pausing. Damn. Respect. Thank you. I'm back ready. That was really good. The game would be ruined if not.
Yes.
Alright. Nice. So Poles for me versus Mongols. Ooh, fun matchup. Wow. Okay. Stream sniping with a good guy. Someone in the chat for sure told him. He's not stream sniping. Yeah, stream sniping, like he's cheating, but like man, he's using it for good, you know what I mean? He's using it for good. Excuse all the clicking, I'm just kind of practicing with my keyboard. I'm not actually doing anything with the clicks. I'm going crazy with the clicking, but it's not doing anything, don't worry. Just practicing some clicking patterns. ...3,086 games amounts to 43 days of life, assuming 20 minutes per game. Damn. I played 43 days. Probably more than that, probably 50 days on this account. My movement is insane, thank you, man. I mean, I don't really feel bad. It's my job. Probably should be more, if anything. What's the advantage of the special mill of Poles? Oh, chat, why don't you go ahead and answer that? Help Kerium, or Kerium, to understand the full work. Sorry, I completely butchered your name, but the chat will help you. It's not 20%, it's 10%, Gibbs. 10%. Even if you weren't getting paid for something you enjoy, you should never be ashamed of the time invested. I somewhat agree with that, yeah. But I do think you could go overboard with hobbies. You can even go overboard with work, though, to be fair, right? Balance is important. It's also a house, yeah, true. This is a house and a mill. The detail, some nice stuff there on the outside. Drush again. Drushing versus Poles is pretty good, but actually, it's kind of like minute arm timing for Mongols. Actually, it's minute arm timing. I wanna go archers. Yeah. Why are you beefing with that guy? Triple's deal with Magadai late game? It's very difficult. Like, Magadai Hisar beats bull composition, but Arbalest Winged Hisar is probably the way to play as pulls. Yeah, just Arbalest Winged Hisar is good. I don't know why I did that house. That house is fine. There comes the Men at Arms. Important is to just wall the gold here. Very important. And as far as the wood goes, we can just do a house here. And then house here. And I'm pretty well defended already. Yeah, he's trapped there. Don't know what he thought he can do there, but not sure about that one, bro. What, he lost his mind or what here? His tower. He's been towers to me every single game, bro. What is he doing behind this? You have a range or what? Oh, forward range. He's been doing this all day against me. I'm 100% sure that NBL did. Someone did this against NBL. NBL lost. He was lower rated player. And now NBL thinks the 4 range is like insane. Like this build order is like insane. Like that's 100% what happened. We can just go heavy on stone now. To repulse. Might have to do a tower here. I don't need to wall, it's fine. Honestly, don't need to wall here. I'm chilling. I'll just defend with my military instead. That tower on top really helps out. Counterattack won't do much, but He's really good at defending the counterattacks, I've noticed. That's my personal biggest weakness. Whenever I try to forward, I always add a counterattack, but against NBL, it's almost like it's not worth it for me to counterattack even. Even though it's usually a good idea. I'm gonna go for a stable defensively. Is this enough food income so I can go up? He's always a hill. Like he's always backing up into a hill, bro. Every game. Every engagement, he's always near a hill. I don't know if he's doing it on purpose or just like lucky. I have no idea. I'm always fighting downhill though for some reason. Let's try to take the hill here. Alright, he's pretty duds. Just gotta make sure he doesn't wall in his units here. Alright, he is pretty toast. I'm gonna play Night Skirm and castle. Did you really tower for folds? Yeah, I'm not sure why actually. That's a good point. I'm gonna make a castle on his face. Once I get the castle edge, we'll do multiple castles on his face actually. I wonder if he's gonna be faster castish than me. I think he's already up because his score is so freaking low, but I'm not 100%. He's going stables. He's gonna go camel probably. So I can probably stop making skirmishes. What? Hello there. That's actually pretty worrying though. I'm gonna get an outpost. I think that's from old though. That's old. Yeah, he's up faster. It's kind of the whole idea of his rush. He like puts pressure and then he greeds up the castle edge. And then he plays from there. But in this case, I don't think he did that much damage to me. So he will be faster castle. I have a much stronger economy. Castle on his gold? Oh yeah, I'm gonna castle his nose here. Don't worry. Just waiting to get the proper setup. Oh my god, I mean, what? So random. He's going crossbow after showing me stable. That's actually a lot of damage he just did. I mean, this castle should be really good though. Yeah, that should be fine. I'm gonna get the knight upgrade now. Actually, best thing to do is add economy, honestly. Because since I've lost some bills, best thing to do is actually just add economy. It's not the most fun thing to do, but it's the best. Ideally, I don't want to make a single knight that's full price. I want to get the upgrade first. But I have to make a few knights, of course, to defend myself. There we go. I want to do second castle at home, I think. Or actually, no, forward castle would be amazing. Never mind. Forward castle again would be amazing. Okay, that's the last upgrade I need. Now I'm full build basically. Killing his houses is extremely important, by the way. It's a good way to stay active. For free, I'm not losing anything killing houses. I'm gonna get a big surge of food in soon. I'm gonna go Obo. Oh, I already tech into the knights though. Let's go cheaper knights. I could go Obo, but I'll go cheaper knights. Just gonna tech into upgrade. Trying to boom. This way. I feel like I'm overwhelming him eventually here. I just hope I'm not taking too long to kill and letting him time to catch up. I don't think that's the case though. I want to get herbal medicine maybe. That could be nice. Bot Panero is pretty cool too. I'll try to go for some herbal medicine here. Some herbs. I'm gonna play Brain Dead All in Castle here. I should just go Imp, but I wanna go Brain Dead All in Castle. I will mess so many knights and just kill everything he has. That's what I wanna do. Like I said, it's not good. Better is Imp, but. Let's do it. Let the nightstand begin. Right at the castle, I'm diving. This is super branded. He's Imp? How did you manage Imp? You have no resources. hope Emil likes that corner, I'm not gonna lie. He might spend more time in that corner than he anticipated. These are the worst trades I've ever taken in my entire life. These are literally the worst trades I've ever taken. Yeah, let's go imp now. Okay, kinda have him walled in right now. Can't really engage though. It's like my units don't cost much, but it'll literally be the worst trade of the century. Let's do it just for fun. Just for the people. Come see the worst trade of the century here. Versus camels. And he's got a defensive castle and monks, and he's gonna obviously walk back to the hill just for the people to enjoy the big battle. Let's see how decent this is. My units don't cost anything though, like it's so unfair. Poles are so dumb, like. These are knights I'm making, by the way. I'm making literal knights. Like look at my queue. Holy moly. Damn. Poles is crazy, man. Kind of a walled in situation for MVL though. That was actually kind of brutal, I'm not gonna lie. He's laughing as well. It's like there's nothing you can really do about it. I was literally just walling him, taking all the stone on the map, and just gonna continue spamming. Oh, he was just about to get heavy camo, perfect engagement. True, actually. It was a dumb engagement for me as well. I should not have taken that fight. Should wait for my upgrades, because I don't know when his upgrade is kicking in, but I mean, this is ridiculous. My knights are beating his camo, under his castle, under his monks. It's so insane. That civ is absolutely incredible. What do you think about the increased cost of unique tech to 700 food and 500 gold? I don't think that's the... No. The unique tech is actually fine. That's not what makes Pulse strong. What makes Pulse strong is the farming economy, which is better than slabs by far, and also the stone to gold ratio. The unique tech for Pulse is perfectly priced. I'll tell you why. You need to get a window in which you can spam knights before they become really bad because they don't have the best upgrades on Cavalier in the world, right? So the knights being spammed, that's a good area for Pulse to thrive on, you know?